Now we shall discuss the effective ways of structuring a manuscript.
Most papers within the physical sciences share the same overall structure and function. The main purpose is to display the right level of knowledge, skills, expertise, and professionalism. The title should describe your contribution without being too vague. Your abstract is the summary and should attract the reader to read the full version. The introduction should contain the background, the study question, and purpose statement. The main text should represent your original scholarly work. The conclusion highlights your expert contribution to the field. And finally, the references list the sources you use to support the text. Many disciplines follow the IMRED structure, meaning introduction, methods, results, and discussion, which mirrors the method of scientific reasoning. These sections are usually presented in the order of the acronym, however, there are some variations on this. For example, after the introduction, the methods and results could be combined for each method, and then an overall discussion and conclusion section. More commonly, in the physical sciences, you have the introduction, and then the methods or experimental, and a combined results and discussion section, which may or may not include a separate final conclusion section. The final draft of a manuscript should be able to answer the following four questions. Why you did the study? What you did and what you found? And how your study contributes to the field? It is important when an editor is reviewing your paper that you have provided answers for each of these questions. There are two factors that should be considered separately when writing your manuscript. First, focus on logically organizing your ideas. You can do this by preparing an early draft of the title and abstract to help you identify your key messages. Then prepare a topic outline. Expand on this outline until it becomes a draft. Rearrange and revise this draft as many times as needed. Once the draft is in its final stages, only then focus on communicating in English. Review and edit the manuscript for language. You can then finalize your abstract and title at the very end of the writing process. A common question from researchers is how to begin planning a paper. While your findings form the basis of your manuscript, these are your original contributions to the field. So when planning your manuscript, it is a good idea to use your data as the starting point. First, make the figures and tables based on your findings, and then arrange them in a logical order. While your findings form the basis of your manuscript, these are your original contributions to the field. So when planning your manuscript, it is a good idea to use your data as the starting point. First, make the figures and tables based on your findings, and then arrange them in a logical order. Determine the logic first and use this as a guide for your outline. However, your logical order depends on the main message of your data. You may need to discuss what the main message is with your co-authors and decide what order works best. You could use the order that you did the tests or experiments in, or you could try by presenting the least important results first and then the most important results, or the other way around. Another way is to state general findings before specific ones, or simple ones before complex ones, or going from whole to parts or parts to whole. When you have put your illustrations in order, you will be able to see if there are any gaps in the message or logic. You may still have time to perform extra tests or analyses to complete your story. At this point, you are ready to write the outline.